What a nice 30-minute nap. Next, we have iambob versus Cookie Creeper. So, iambob does have a fair chance of beating Cookie Creeper here. The ships are quite agile and should stay away. However, Cookie Creeper does have those sentinel missiles, so we'll see how well iambob can defend against those. It does seem like they're quite evenly matched. Dicey for Cookie Creeper here, but not anymore. iambob successfully focus fired down one of Cookie Creeper's creepers, and he does have a significant point advantage. iambob takes round one. He is not doing as well this time though. Already has lost one ship. Seems like iambob just couldn't get around the creepers here, weak side, fast enough. But he still can't win this. Very close. You can see that these flurry missiles might not have enough damage per second to stop the armor from regenerating. Two kiters on it. Looks like it worked. Just needs to defeat one more creeper, and he could win this. And he does successfully destroy all the creepers. Now, versus another sentinel design, it might go the same way. However, Lyolf's ships are much faster and do have the Gauss drones, which are very effective at taking down kiters. And that's your scene right here. iambob is definitely not doing as well versus these much faster and longer range sentinels. Takes that. Cerzei's submission is very fast, but as long as these kaijus can pop the shields, it only takes a few hits for them to take down these water ships. But it seems like he's just not able to get any hits in. And Cerzei has a lead. Cerzei has not lost any ships yet, and iambob is down to one ship. It doesn't look like iambob has the point defense necessary to take down all those drones, but he still can't get a hit with these much weaker armor missiles. There's now a very large drone swarm, but iambob's last ship is escaping for now. Now he's surrounded, let's see if he can escape. He's a squad by Cerzei, wins round one. Looks like iambob is faring a little bit better this time, but two of his ships are already down in the seconds I said that. Again. It only takes one mortar shot for Cerzei to destroy iambob's ships after the shields go down. Versus the fly swarm, it may be difficult for iambob to get any hits at all, because these flies just teleport out of the way, unless they're out of energy. You can already see two of iambob's ships spinning out of control. Shields are holding. Majority of the swarm is down in this place. The skill still has the majority of the swarm still alive. Skill takes round one. That is unfortunate. does seem like after the initial rush by the dagger swarm, iambob's ships are able to fend off the flies quite well. You can see the shields are still up. Even against around half of the swarm in this area. Bob can just kill a few more ships, I think he might be able to take it. But he is having trouble killing these flies with missiles. There are no point losses on either side for a while now, except their skill lost some points, but still takes it, winning by points. Now, up against Simplechrom, these Borg drones are very effective at taking down kiters, and it doesn't look good because there is quite a large drone swarm already, and they're slowly focusing down each one of iambob's ships, one at a time. Simplechrom wins. Additionally to the drone swarm, these farmer missiles just can't get past the Borg lasers, easily swatting down anything that gets close. Perhaps farmer on farmer might do better against Exterp. The ships are getting too close, and he's already down in points. And you see, even a small ship is able to swat down most of these missiles very easily, even from three ships. And he's lost another ship. iambob's ships definitely can't deal with Exterp's fleet one-on-one. They would have to group together and focus fire. Getting too close there. Yeah, but it looks like even versus two ships, iambob just can't get the missiles to get through all this point defense. And his third ship is spinning out of control. That looks like he gained it. Close. Only two ships remaining, and it doesn't seem like either side is able to get an answer. But spinning out of control here. Looks like he was able to escape. Former Republic Light Division. Lose a match. Versus another Borg submission. It would be very challenging for iambob to get through all those lasers. And debris just mercilessly focuses down one by one and wins. iambob can get around to the backside, and they have a better chance because debris ships can't really go backwards or turn very well. But again, missiles can't get through the point fence. He's doing better this time, trying to take out some distractors with these points, but I'm not sure it's enough. Versus the famous Inu. You can see iambob ships immediately evaporated by mortars. Now that they are keeping the distance, they have a better chance. But first lasers, also very dangerous weapons. Good at popping their shields. As the rest of the Inu's fleet engages. Very hard for iambob to get this. Surrounded on all sides. Bursted down. And then he takes round one. Ships immediately go in. It does seem like they were able to get one shield down, but it's up again. Got too close there. Versus Angel takes her more. Is doing better this time, still has all five of his ships. And if he this, he might be able to get a win on points. Looking to do a little more damage. Bob is definitely putting up more of a fight this time. But there goes his first ship. And another one is just surrounded. Ship. Maybe he can survive this, but Joyous closes in. Oh, I think he did survive that. Joyous won. Maybe less. Now, Imperiex and Slime Mold. I do think that if iambob ships behave correctly, they can. And perhaps win this action. I think a lot of slime mold is on point defense, so it'll be hard to get through all the boards. And Bob ships are behaving much better compared to other guiders that have just rushed in and been eaten. Question is, can they kill the slime mold fast enough before it wins on points? It does look like they're a little too far away now. Just too many bullets, and those Sparrow missiles only take one shot to kill. They have like something stupid, like 3 health or something. And these jellyfish cannons do much more than 3 damage. But slowly but surely, iambob is taking out these ships. I think he's doing the best so far out of all the competitors. Closer to get those hits in. Looks like they get a couple more. But he wasn't fast enough. Imperiex takes round one. Maybe we're better this time. This one, that's 2. That's 3 is 4. That's a lot more. It does seem like these multi-core don't work too well, because as soon as the main core is, or if cores are just detached, they just sit there or they despawn. So now they just disappear. Just this one. Yeah, I think it's just too much pee for jellyfish. I might make them have acceleration requirement, so more of the pee goes into thrusters and not weapons. And now, Laps is... Did I introduce Laps? Ships are doing very well. You can see distractors are doing their job and then battleships going attack. Involved ships are having trouble again getting past the point defense. Six round one. Just in case I didn't actually introduce Lapsus fleet already, here it is. He's got these mini plasma projector distractors. You saw they're doing a very good job last round. You got these main shielded attack ships, which have a shield, flat cannons, and plasma cannons and auto cannons. They should go in close range and engage enemy. And then you have these missile ships, which stay back while enemy is dealing with the first two ships and shower them with those very good Terran missiles. Lapse's fleet composition is very common with a few people go in front and then some ships that stay back and snipe them far. But it seems like these kiters are now exposed. No more shield in front of them. And iambob is doing much better this time. Seems like Lapse's kiters are much faster than him. Points are much more even this time. So those have around 20 points of point advantage, and all iambob needs is a few more points and he can Laps takes it. It seems like I did not introduce Laps, so it's a good thing I did the second time. And now we have two sentinel submissions versus each other. And Cookie Keeper would be much more resilient versus these Goss drones, but it seems like half of his ship was cut in half by one of these spikers. And that's not good, but looks like didn't have enough speed to slice through. But it seems like Lyolf's ships are much faster and Cuckoo Peeper's not able to catch up, but they are chilling them, so I should not have said that. They're doing very well. Is able to take down the main ship. Cooper's ships are pretty much the pinnacle of Sentinel, just big blobs of armor, just able to take more damage than their enemy. Back is exposed to these guiders and doesn't have too much backwards thrust or turning thrust to turn around and engage them. So it's looking a little dicey. But Cookie Cooper wins that round with all the ships intact. Bad. As I said when I introduced Lyolf's ship, this ship is weak to splash from the back, so you see all this. And it's turning, so it doesn't really matter anymore. It just seems like these sentinel spikes can't just pierce through other sentinels like they can other ships, and the weak spot of this one just died, and so spikes just fell off. Cookie Keeper has only lost 80 points. Ships don't really know how to slice through enemies and just kind of hover around a little. I don't really know why that didn't slice through, but okay. Like Cooper wins again, all his forces intact. And versus the laser swap by Cerzei. Cerzei, if he can get around Cookie Cooper, he can just one shot those very exposed cores. Well, not one shot, because Sentinel's cores are very strong. But he is getting very close on that. This one. Seems like it is surrounded by armor, so it is more durable. And although Cerzei's ships can outmaneuver, they just are not smart enough to not charge in an enemy around 10 times their size and 10 times their HP. Maybe more, 100 times their HP.
idea. But Cookie protects that.
Like, cerzei is behaving a little better this time, just sitting back and listening, and there they go. That's not good. Spaceships are definitely not suiciding as much this time. They are maneuvering around to try to take out that core. Looks like they've almost succeeded. There we go. Mortar blast. That's not a good idea. I mean, you can try it, but not a good idea. Shields are down. Not very good. And Cookie Keeper wins it. Now versus skill, I think will be interesting because I'm not sure if Cookie Keeper can destroy these flies with lasers, but I'm not sure if these flies can do any damage to these Coopers either. But it does look like he is somehow managing probably those flurry missiles from the sentinels. These flurry missiles are much better than the sparrow missiles. They shoot faster, I think, and they move faster, they have more range, they have more health. And they cost the same amount of P for some reason, so. Yeah. These missiles are doing very well. Flies can't really surround large targets like this and deal enough damage to prevent regeneration. Even with the majority of the swarm right here firing in one spot, you don't see any pieces breaking. Cooper did very well, almost taking out the entire swarm. I kind of think this round might go the same way unless the flies in their initial rush can take down one of the creepers. Not to be. Cookie Creeper retains most of his points. You can see the flies did manage to break two of the blocks on this, but and it is enough to prevent regeneration, but it is not enough to kill it. Cookie Creeper takes that. Now versus these longer range ships. Not really sure these Borb drones are going to be able to get through all this armor either. But it seems like Sunkelgrum is keeping his distance, and there is a very large swarmer here. Fortunately, they're mostly taken down as soon as they spawn. But it does seem like the Creepers have a very hard time turning around and following these spawners as they escape and drones accumulate. Well, not really, but they are doing damage. It's not looking good. If Cookie Green loses one ship, I don't think he'll be able to make up the points unless the spawners come back around. But this very last layer of armor is sentinel armor, so it is much stronger, much harder to destroy. Looks like the drones were distracted and this creeper is spared. Regenerated back to full. Points are now skewing in Sumpelcrumb's favor as he starts to damage these thrusters on the outside of the points. Takes round one. Looks like they were able to destroy one block of armor, but some crumb with no points. Does look like the Creepers are getting dangerously close. Not looking good. This one kind of been battered around pretty badly. And this one is disabled. These thrusters are mostly gone. Some Chrome ships couldn't get out of the way fast enough, but maybe this last Kiter can deal enough damage to regain the points he's lost. I don't think it'd be possible though, because the Creepers are bunched together, and they're pulling the fencing all up together to take down any swarm of drones that might want to spawn. Creeper takes round two. Deciding factor is if some of the ships decide to dodge or not. When they get backed up against the wall, it's all over for them. The wall is approaching. Trooper Squadron. It's one ship. Two ships. And again. Dude. Fancy flying that time. I just can't get away. Has kind of come a long way with his creepers from when they were first submitted in MLT. He's using mostly shields, and shields are not really effective compared to armor. And now, to now, they're almost winning every fight. Just large blocks of armor. They're creepers. They're beautiful. Expect this will feel the same way. I'm not sure if someone can take out this ship, even if it does. And Trooper Federation wins it. Now versus Exterp, another Kyder-oriented fleet, but they are getting very close to the creepers. Not a good idea. Not a good idea at all. But now that they've lost their initial forward rush, not able to maneuver, might be that Exterp is might be able to kite them, as long as the shields don't go down. But it looks like it's going to be crushed against the wall. Very bad. And this last ship, it was destroyed. If Exter tries to keep his distance more this time, he might have a much better chance, but the same strategy seems to be going through the former Republic Light Division's pilots' minds. Just charge forward and don't run away, because that's just not a good idea. Regenerates just in time. Now onto debris. Creeper does have enough armor to tank quite a bit of drones, and he's able to outbrawl these laser-only submissions. And it's taken much longer for these world lasers to drill through to the core. Looks like Cookie Creeper might win this. Well, the Green still has six ships, which I'm not sure how, but Cookie Creeper was winning. I guess not. Drone Swarm just grows too large. And it's easily able to, well, not easily able to, but it does get through the Sentinel armor. Cooper does have most of the debris to be surrounded, and they're pounding away. You just can't focus on a single target to destroy it. Debris is using up points currently. But it seems like this is a battle of two. Two ships that just can't maneuver very well. And so, since the Borg do have longer range weapons, they don't really need a maneuver. Well, Cookie Bird does need a maneuver to get into firing range. There isn't too much of a drone swarm. Cookie Trooper's point defense is able to take out most of it. Very dicey though. Down to one ship. Creepers might be the first ones to beat debris. On to the third round. Swarm is being suppressed by the plasma bolts, but the core armor is just exposed and it's only one layer. Cookie Trooper can just survive 30 more seconds. He might be the first competitor to win a match against Debris Submission. But looks like Cookie Creeper lost another ship. Just one more ship, come on. Kill it. I guess it's just not meant to be. Ships do also have mortars, so they are able to snipe the back of the core. But they are getting very close. Not a good idea versus Sentinels. But their shields are holding. Well, this ship's shield helped, but not another one, apparently. Because one of them died. Bites the dust. down into two ships, with one being disabled. Only a core left. Shut down for missiles. And only the missile ship left. It'll be tricky because Cooper Keeper still has all of his ships left. Goku Creeper takes round one. That's not good. The Bastion right there. It's dead. Looks like the core is being attacked, but it's not damaged. The ship is slowly trying to get away out of that core. That ship just exploded. Again, he was just unable to get through this central armor. However, this ship was smoking. Not damage enough. These missile carriers are still alive. They just don't have enough damage to keep these peepers from regenerating. I think Cookie Peepers' designs are just a testament to that. Oh, look at that. I'm saying Cookie Peepers' designs are testament that you can make bricks that look very cool. It is technically a brick, but I like how it looks. And he was doing much better, because he did take out two peepers in quick succession. Yenyu's first loss, as far as I'm concerned. And because Drills here has brought a monoship submission, none of his ships are specialized to take out these creepers, and they're just staying in range of the creeper's guns. However, it looks like he might be able to snipe the core in the back. But as this last distraction is being destroyed, the rest of the cooking creepers will come and aid this one. He's already sort of not losing. There's almost three ships, and the peepers are trying to maneuver it to help their brother. Feels the ships are pretty well behaved when they are damaged. They seem to retreat and let another one take damage while that they regen, but they use teamwork to take down one ship at a time. And there's another very easy exposed core. But now they're moving to the front of it, which is does he want to shoot at? It does seem like missiles from the ship are being shut down. Point defense. Take the first round. Creeper's damage, but its core is still protected. And this brass ship is just not able to outbrawl a sentinel all by itself. Ships might have enough health to just survive this hellstorm of bullets. Just maybe. They're doing very well, just plowing right through. But it does look like they're very. Last one. Doing much better than any other competitor before him. Almost half of the fleet, half of the slime mold is destroyed. But it is not a good idea to go in half regenerated. So, although you are faster, you are much weaker. Still alive though. That's all that counts. As the creepers go in, this one's running backwards, which is not a good idea. And can't catch up with the recoil of the cannons. And this creeper is disabled. I didn't even notice he had a little thruster there. They did do very well. Taking down 2/3 of the fleet before losing on points, so hopefully they can do a little better this time, maneuver a little better. This creeper is just going right through and rolling most damage. But it's core is all by itself. She's a little core trapped in the middle of enemy territory. It's gonna regenerate very quickly before we don't go forward. That is not a good idea. It does seem like this creeper right here is slated to charge forward again for another one. Cowabunga. Go get him. Is taking a very large amount of damage. He is able to take out a lot of jellyfish. He did much better this time, so that's 30 seconds left to close the point gap. So we do see it is possible to beat this thing. And it is possible to beat debris. As shown by Cuckoo Cooper. Very effective designs. Although they do have a bit of trouble turning. They just require a little bit of optimization. It works out. Looks like... almost. 10 points away. That's frustrating. Maps does have a similar food composition to Yenyu. But he doesn't have any mortars, so he might find it a little more difficult to get through. To damage those cores. However, he does have much faster kiter, so they should stay farther back, and they do have a lot more missiles, so I get the snipe from before. Can they do it in 1 minute? Remains to be seen. To get close to these things. Still has one distractor. Distracting very well, although it might not be necessary because the missiles have attacked him before. Missile kiters can fit much more missiles on them since they do not have a shield and therefore are much more able to deal damage and get through. Lapses do considerably better this time, but he still has a attack ship still alive, but it is getting dangerously close. Federation Task Force Beta. silent. I wanted to make Joyce count more subs. Congratulations, you've made this tournament 30 minutes longer. These first ships are these little distractors armed with only armor spikes, and they do not break the rules because armor spikes do technically count as weapons, as they do a lot of damage. And they will fly around, distract, and hopefully spike people. And then he has these main ships called the Old Faithful or something, and they're just five annihilators surrounded by armor. And they should be quite quick and quite damaging. And as the distractors distract, these annihilators with lots of splash, and they have a chance to splash down these weak spots in the rear. Unfortunately for these distractors, they are also weak to splash, so Cuckoo Cooper does not have any non-splash weapons. Sentinel. He has more armor. I don't think he has more armor. Though, Insane Asylum does have much more firepower, as he's able to almost destroy one block per shot. Or, I mean, a group of blocks per shot. Against weaker Hull, he would definitely be doing much more damage, as he would be able to actually one-hit blocks, which left his paper is disabled. Or something, whatever it's called, he's able to take out one creeper. But most of the fleet was in distractors, so it would be very hard for him to make up the points. And Creeper Federation takes round one. Spiky ships are just, they are able to make little holes, but they just aren't heavy enough to cleave right through these sentinel ships. Head on, not a good idea. That's the most armored part of the creeper. Cuckoo Cooper is currently leading on points. Powerful splash attacks, blood and spread fires, and Creeper Federation takes the match. I do think Cookie Keeper is in the lead with 12 wins. Next up is Lyolf. And his ships are much more maneuverable than Cookie Keeper's, so maybe they will be able to succeed where the AI failed him. Currently he is not winning against cerzei, which is a little unexpected because those Goss drones should be able to burst down their shields and destroy him. Seems like cerzei is able to face tank Lyolf's ships. So Lyolf just doesn't have that brawling potential. And splash weapons just annihilate. He's very cool, but mostly made of adapters and subsequently very weak splash ships. But he's shooting the armor and he did break through. But usually grinding yourself on a spike is just not wise. And Lyolf takes the win back. Cerzei is not doing as well this time, it seems like. Lyolf ships learn their lessons. Or maybe Cerzei made a mistake somewhere along the line. Should be made. And Lyolf still has all of his ships. That was a pretty meaty mortar hit though. He's swarmed by drones. And destroyed. Lyolf takes the match. Versus this fly swarm. Lyolf does actually have lasers in the form of Goss drones, so he might be able to do more damage than Cookie Cooper. His fleet is spread out everywhere. But they are able to take care of all these flies. It does seem like these spiker ships are having much more trouble. They can't hit anything, and they just can't ram them either. Oh, looks like they hit something. And these titers are just too fast for the flies to focus down. one chip remaining. Still slowly losing points. And Lyolf has only lost 90. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 100. Ships. Maybe not. The flies are able to teleport. That was 2 ships remaining. Lyolf still wins. Now, sample crumb. I'm not sure if these Borg drones can take through this armor, but I'm not sure if the Sentinels have enough point defense to kill these. Well, the Borg certainly do have plenty of point defense. It looks like this one got a little too close. And it's done too wrong. It does seem like these drones just keep getting distracted and can't focus down and sliced in half, and some crumb is a point disadvantage, but these drones are getting very close to the core. But Lyolf takes it. Ship is disabled and destroyed. Warp drones do have tractor force, I believe, so they, if they start firing, they enough of them start firing, then they will immobilize their target eventually. Theoretically. Right in there, and just boops him on the nose and dies. Is not having a good time either. Gosh, drones should have very easy time getting through these shields. Ships just don't seem to have the DPS to get through the central armor. Lyolf has not lost any ships. Exterp is down to half of his fleet. Struggling to survive. Drones and missiles coming in from every angle. Lyolf takes round two. Lose the match. Now, versus the shredded debris. All the drones and missiles are being shot down by the lasers. His only hope is to try to slice through, but it seems like there wasn't enough momentum. It's just being distracted. And as the blueprints spawn, things are looking grim for Lyolf, although he does have a point advantage. But debris is very quickly closing the gap. Titers left. And Titers don't do very well against fast drones like these. Especially drones that immobilize their prey. one chip remaining. And the simulation wins. Again. I can slice through something, but this large chip is just not fast enough to gain any momentum to slice. And looks like this one was able to slice through. But three blue sprints have already been unleashed. And a lot of this feed is distracted. The core is being attacked. So the armor spikes on this ship have been destroyed. And it doesn't seem to want to charge anyway. But the plasma bolts did their best, but simulation wins. On against Yenji. And your ships do have mortars, so they are able to get past all this armor almost instantly. See, there there's two meaty mortars to get a lot of functionals. Or, never mind. I am wrong. Ship have a bit of trouble taking on this larger ship. As you can see, they were outgalled and cut in half by the point. But they are attempting to go through the very armored side. And but it seems like they are able to. One chip remaining. Maybe wins round one. See. These ships are lethal against skiders, but not against these because they just get cut. Those close range plasma swords aren't very good at close range because if they get close, they get sliced in half. Lyolf is doing much better this time. But his muscle ships are still alive and trying to hunt down those kiters, which can't really escape the missiles. And he still has one mortar laser ship. Very dangerous. The kiter is able to dodge for quite a while. And the second kiter on the other side is spinning out of control. Never a good thing for any ship, unless it's supposed to spin. See, this kiter is not helping his friend. so we're about even. And you has a slight advantage. Meaty. Whack as that mortar hits. And the lasers goes away. Lose the points. And you has a lead. Just barely. Stealing that round and the match with Lyolf. Now against Drills, I think Lyolf will do a little bit better. Drills didn't have any big splash weapons. But his ships are very good at staying together and hunting down Lyolf's smaller ships, one by one. Ships, though, have enough weapons to defend themselves, though they're essentially sitting targets. Unless they can somehow ram, but there's not a lot of rams. It does seem like Lyolf's kiters are able to stay out of range. But Drill's ships are much more armored than Yenyu's and were able to actually go through the front instead of the back. Very surprising. Like the angle is all wrong now, so but now as the crab turns around, it's not looking good. And Drills wins that. Is being outbrawled right here. Only barely. But the ship goes escape and his friends come in. As I said before, very good at hunting in the back. Now as this spice ship is singled out. Lyolf's other distractors, or kiters, are being distracted. But there we go. Drills has still not lost a ship. Imperiax's slime mold. Hopefully, these ships will just slice right through. Beautiful. Beautiful. But they are heavily damaged, and if they can't escape right now, it's not going to look good. Now, this main ship does have quite a bit of armor, but it's just being pushed back and eaten alive. Wow! It's been cut in several pieces. That is a terrifying swarm. Lyolf has only lost one ship, so he does still have a good chance. These kiters are fast enough to evade these slower jellyfish bullets. Ship heading back into battle. Hopefully able to cut through a large chunk. But it looks like it just... There we go. That's satisfying. Jellyfish have lost enough cores that you can actually see their real colors. Interesting. Wow, that is beautiful. But alas, slime mold wins. Round one. Hopefully if the spike ships can go right through and not look back, they'll do a little better. The sides, so you don't go in the middle, but just cleave through that like butter. A very scary submission by Reassembly here. If you just have a straight shot through this line, might do enough damage to it. But it looks like having the same trouble as Cook the Poopers, just not enough training thrust. Not having a good time. Takes it. Now versus Laps. Laps does have a few missiles, but no plasma mortars. Laps' ships are able to dodge these spikes. It seems like he's only lost one distractor. not looking good for now. This main ship is being targeted. And although it's going to take a while to get through that armor, the big crab is not able to fight back. It is very close. Very close. The big ship is destroyed. And Laps wins round one. Lapses attack ships, since they are the same, they share the same attack pattern, and thruster patterns are very good at hunting as a pack. Slowly eat away at his armor. But the kiter comes in to distract. But those kiters are still very dangerous. These kiters. The death of the big crab, unfortunately. Sorry about that. And when he lapses, he holds quite a decisive lead in points. Doesn't look good for Lyolf. Lapse takes it. Now, Insane Asylum. Distractors, distracting very well. Same sound, so that's all the ships. Asylum is losing it. Much likely because the splash opens damage the annihilators in the middle, and that counts for points. Looks like Satan Asylum is staying in the lead. But we might lose it soon. The ship is disabled. Yeah. coming in. This is coming in. So they're much more even this time. Insane Asylum was a slight lead. That lead is a little bigger now. Which was the big crab. It's pretty, pretty decent. Sounds distracted, doing very well. Distracting most of the fleet now. These annihilator destroyers destroy things. And the same sound takes it. Cerzei versus skill. It could go either way, honestly. Cerzei does have a bunch of burst lasers, but skill will be able to swarm individual ships, take down the shields, and kill them. Maybe. Maybe not. Seems like Cerzei is fast enough to not be focused fired. The ships are quite fast and agile. Looks like Cerzei might win by destroying all the flies. Those burst lasers are quite effective. Very effective. Cerzei is not losing many points. Those Terran shields are quite good at shrugging off light damage. Four flies remain. Can perhaps accumulate enough to take down a shield and rip apart the squishy insides. And looks like mortar shots are easily able to core some of them ships. But getting close to the enemy as a very unarmored light craft is not a good idea. And the drone swarm has accumulated enough, and some of the crumb wins round one. If Cerzei can just get three good mortar hits, they can detach the core from the rest of the body and make them sitting ducks. There was one ship remaining. Cerzei might be able to do this. Something from wins, if just barely. This is Exterp. Cerzei's fleet should perform very well. The burst laser taking down the shield and the mortar should finish him off with the rest. As well as drones harrying the enemy. One ship remaining on the next side. This one takes round one. As a squad does defeat the Farmer Federation, or Farmer Light Division, something. Versus debris, it is not a good idea to get close, but looks like mortars just can't penetrate through armor. Again, those big splash explosions are good, but they just can't reach the core. Spaced armor is quite good for that reason. I am fairly certain debris purposely made armor just wide enough to block mortar shots, so it could get bursted down. Now the enemy ships, which is Cerzei, they're both built pretty similarly. Mortar and something to take down shields. And so the ships hunting as a pack, taken down one by one, but got too close and got burned by the sword. This really is a lazy, quote-unquote lazy submission, then is doing very well. And if I didn't know any better, I think I might have put a little more time into it than he thought. They are beating in you this time. One ship remaining. Nimbus. Ships. Or ship. Dodging drones. Not daring to get close. Because AI is not very smart. Seconds left. And he's not getting close to finished off the last two ships. Or three ships. With his squad. Brings round two. Cerzei is not doing as well this time. The ships just got too close to the swords early on. But so the ships are fast enough to match with the mutant. If they get close, the shields go down, which is very bad for them. Next, there's the drills. 5v5. Drill ships are more armored and slower, but I'm not sure if that armor will do much against those mortars. Drills is winning so far. Seem like there is a squad member, but a friend comes to the rescue. Drills takes it. On to Imperial X. Seriously, you definitely can't get close because this very unarmored ship will just melt. Like that. The mortar shots hitting these jellyfish are incredibly satisfying though. Beautiful. burst lasers are capable of one-shotting these jellyfish.
Oh.
Cerzei ships do quite well for being very unarmored, but Kieran has 100 points left and Pyrex has 100 times more points in him. Cerzei, ships seem to have learned their lesson and not going in the main swarm and just kiting around the outside. Except for that one ship that just ignored me. Spinning water rounds. Oh, that was beautiful. But he survives. The power of spinners, everyone. Cerzei almost 9. Almost 7,000 points. Cookie Creeper did better. Laps. His fleet composition is also quite strong. But can they survive all these mortar shots? It remains to be seen. Sides are pretty evenly on points. The lapse has a slight advantage. Since they ships. Get the shields of back in these, it seems. Oh, but it looks like the points have evened out. Cerzei might win this by a whole 4 points. Almost had it. Seems like because certain ships can't really control themselves very well, or as much, drills and ships are much better pack hunters, even though they're both submissions with one type of ship. Points are about even, but Cerzei just lost a ship. A 100 points is around 100 damage, so all Cerzei needs is one mortar hit. Wins it. Is this line here yellow? Yellow and not yellow. Has Lolo fought debris? I think he has, that's... I don't know what you guys got the number. 10. It's 11. Okay. Now these are both splash-heavy submissions, and I do believe Cerzei's burst laser should be able to burst down these distractors before they can be a problem. They could just completely ignore distractors and go for main ships. So as of now, Cerzei has a small opponent advantage. He has lost 3 ships now. Yeah, distractors are just sentinel distractors, so they are not weak, unlike normal distractors in general, which can't survive a burst laser beam. Down to one chip. Insane Asylum. Wins round one. Chip. Being distracted. This distractor is very well made. They can survive multiple mortar hits or semi-charged mortar hits. Second Asylum wins it. I'm gonna take a break, and you can take a break too. And I'm gonna restart your assembly to make sure things keep running smoothly.